welcome to my spoiler review of Mort of the Discworld series, while I try really hard to paint a fancy dress with a girl in it. I think out of the four drawings I've done so far, this was the hardest for me. I don't normally draw girls, even less so pretty ones in pretty dresses. Originally, I tried to offset the girl with a rather shocked and horny wizard, but I gave up on that composition very quickly. Somewhere halfway through failing to place the nose on the face, I seriously considered just drawing the sacrificial elephant, but I was too pot committed at that point. For anyone watching who's read the book, any guesses on who this is? Out of the four books I've reread so far, I think this is my favorite. As much as I loved Granny's interaction with pretty much anyone in equal rights, I was a lot more invested in the story and the characters in Mort. So, there's this death guy, tall, slim and mysterious, with a voice to die for. Met him a couple of times in the first two books. And he takes on an apprentice, coincidentally also named Mort. And Mort screws up on his very first day working alone. Predictably, he's too terrified to tell his boss and tries to fix the problem himself. Funnily enough, the big, massive, world-altering problem gets fixed off-screen, as in not uncommon in many a Pratchett book, though I could really be remembering it all wrong. Correct me if you know better, right? Besides, with the Discworld books, it's always journey before destination. No, wait, wrong series. Anyway, maybe it's just me, but the big conflict and main storyline in Pratchett books are secondary at best. It's all about the character interactions and the little personal stories and the hilarious narrator voice and, oh yes, all the angry criticism of pretty much everything that's wrong with our world. So that makes the story what? Quaternary? Quinary? I don't even know how to pronounce that word. So, out of the norm, I was heavily invested in the story itself. I last read the book so long ago, I had zero recollection of what actually happened, other than a random scene of death trying to get wasted or musing about sex, which probably tells you more about me than I'm comfortable admitting. I didn't want Princess Kelly to die, which seemed inevitable, and I was very invested in the well-being of the elephant I almost chose to draw for this episode. I liked Mort and found his slow transformation chilling and disturbing, and I was even satisfied with the somewhat offhand explanations about how the death stuff works, which is somewhat unusual for me. There were quite a few science jokes in there that went right over my head, and a good number of references to the other books, which I took great glee in noticing but completely failed to write down. So my one example is the fact that Mort's family specializes in distilling the wine from reannual grapes, like the wine Teth is poured for Rincewind and Two Flower in the Color of Magic. No wait, we also briefly see Rincewind, who's now the librarian's assistant. Good for him! I also chuckled out loud at the mention of the drunk elephant soon to start seeing pink people. Back to the drawing. This was hard. I had no idea what I was doing other than I wanted it to look like the portraits of Queen Elizabeth I. When I showed the sketch to my art teacher, who hasn't seen the final result yet, and frankly, I'm a bit scared of showing him. He seemed confused in a disappointed sort of way before I explained the concept. Yeah, the super stiff and static pose, lack of background and weird boobs, which were unfortunately lost in the final rendering, are all totally on purpose because I'm referencing them old portrait thingies and not because I'm looking for an easy way out, yeah. I've never drawn lace or jewels before, although, admittedly, this type of dress is all I ever drew when I was 5 years old, with a princess in it, of course. This is where I would have liked to insert one of my ancient drawings, but unfortunately I don't have any surviving copies left. I briefly considered adding a massive gold frame around Kelly as a heavy-handed wink to the numerous portraits and posters and reminders she flooded her city with, but A, I could just imagine her striking a portrait pose while wearing that hereditary dress one occupies instead of wearing, in an attempt to look older, more serious, and more queenly. And B, I really didn't want to fail further by attempting to paint a fancy golden picture frame. I'm worried my art teacher will have a panic attack upon seeing this, and possibly kicking me out of our meetings. I'm also getting extremely anxious just thinking of all the corrections he'll propose that I won't be able to publish in this video, as it'll actually come out on time and not a month late, as has been custom here so far. And that about covers it, I think. Next month I'll be rereading Sorcery, and who knows, might do something different and not a digital illustration. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one!